On behalf of the Government of Ireland, I'm delighted to welcome Prime Minister Shinzo Abe to Ireland following his attendance at the GS summit in Lough Erne earlier this week. I had the privilege of sending a letter to Prime Minister Abe a number of months ago, and I really am very pleased that it has been possible for him to visit us here in Dublin and in Ireland on the occasion of the opportunity of his visit to the G8. Let me say to you that we had a very, very good conversation and a very good meeting, and we look forward to continuing these discussions over lunch and later with a number of Japanese, Irish and Irish-Japanese interests upstairs. Let me also tell you, my wife, Fionnuala, is also delighted to have the opportunity to meet privately with Mrs. Abe here in Dublin, where she has made that trip, and she is very welcome also. It's a very significant occasion, as it's the first time since the independence of this state that we've had a visit from a Japanese Prime Minister, and he's exceptionally welcome. So while we're far apart physically and geographically, there's a very warm and close relationship between our countries, with a shared sense of values for the rule of law and for consensus and for trust. We share many common values and political interests. Ireland and Japan have had a trade and investment relationship for over 50 years, and trade between our two countries has increased significantly in the past period. I'm very glad that the Prime Minister has encouraged that there be far greater contact in terms of potential investment either way to improve these standards. So we see great opportunities for working with our Japanese colleagues, arising from the Memorandum of Understanding signed by Minister Shimomura earlier this year in the area of research, in the area of innovation, in the area of education. And we look forward to using those opportunities for economic progress, growth and jobs either way. As I say, after lunch, I expect to engage with the Prime Minister with numbers of Irish and Japanese interests here in Ireland. We also discussed the question of EU-Japan relations, including progress on the EU-Japan trade deal, which Ireland as Presidency was launched during our Presidency, in which we will work to further that. Prime Minister mentioned three particular words that are important to him: challenge, openness and innovation, and arising from this, we're very happy to work in the areas of ageing societies. We know the demographics of Japan, the longest life expectancy of any developed world, and clusters of our pharma, medical devices, academics and universities here will work with our Japanese colleagues. Finally, the Prime Minister has extended a formal invitation to me as Taoiseach to visit Japan. I intend to accept that invitation and thank him very much for so doing, and look forward through the diplomatic services for building a really effective, substantial and beneficial trip to Japan whenever that might be appropriate. Prime Minister Abe.
Country of literature and music and a strong rugby team. Such attractiveness of Ireland is loved by many Japanese. Ireland has maintained a tradition of peace and neutral diplomacy and made major contributions in areas such as demilitarization, non-proliferation, and peace building. She is an extremely important partner for Japan to enhance the stability of the global community and maintain global order in line with the principle of rule of law. On the economic front, I deeply respect the process of Ireland has gone through, diving into the gigantic European market, but even under difficult conditions, not being derailed from the principle of free trade and continue to strive towards growth. Now, under the strong leadership of Taoiseach Kenny, Ireland as the EU presidency is coordinating the efforts of the EU member states while working seriously to free the country from the debt crisis. Ireland's such attitude is to be lauded. And this time, I have shared the same recognition with Taoiseach Kenny that if Japan and Ireland brings together the set of values and diligence that the two countries share, that it would be conducive to the realization of growth. In line with the basic concept embodied in my growth strategy, I have made three proposals having to do with the major direction of the Japan-Ireland cooperation and exchange into the future, which was endorsed by Taoiseach Kenny. Firstly, for human resource development, enabling Japan to actively take on challenges, sending students abroad, exchange of researchers and universities should be promoted. Secondly, promotion of an open trade and investment relationship. I have secured commitment from Ireland, the current presidency of EU, for their cooperation towards an early conclusion of EU-Japan EPA. Thirdly, to promote innovation, to open up our future through the vitalization of exchange in the private sector, including the medical device sector, one of the strongholds of Irish industry, we shall mutually strengthen our competitiveness. And the key words that I have cited had been embraced by Taoiseach Kenny. We believe that we have this common DNA, and those are the three key words. And the world needs a very strong and robust Japanese economy. He had told me that he endorses Abenomics, which had greatly encouraged me. So my visit to Ireland has given new impetus to our bilateral ties. And this time, myself and my wife, Akia, had kindly been invited to Ireland. Once again, I would like to express my appreciation to Taoiseach Kenny for giving me this honorable opportunity to visit your country as the first Prime Minister of Japan. And Taoiseach Kenny, I would like to invite you to Japan, as you have mentioned earlier, and I am delighted that Taoiseach had accepted my invitation. So my visit to Ireland and Taoiseach Kenny's visit to Japan are going to further evolve and develop the bilateral ties. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have time for two questions. The first question is from the National Broadcaster of Ireland, Mr. Sean Whelan, to the Taoiseach.
Encouraged to learn about Abenomics. We're wondering how inspired you might be to try and apply some of the principles of Abenomics here in Ireland to try and boost economic growth here. And would that include a tax cut in the next budget, as suggested by your cabinet colleague, Mr. Richard Bruton, today?
Well, the three words that the Prime Minister mentioned are very important to us: challenge, openness, and innovation. We discussed elements around this and the progress that Ireland has made. Budget, insofar as Ireland is concerned, hasn't been discussed by Cabinet yet. The two Ministers for Finance and Minister for Public Expenditure and Reform will bring a joint memo to Government on the strategy in regard to the budget, which will be held on the 15th of October. I don't expect that the detail of budget will be entered into at this stage. Let me say that it's part of our programme for Government, Sean, that there would not be any increase in income tax. We believe this is fundamental in the context of the creation of jobs and not to put obstacles in the way of jobs being created. As you know, we've set out a strategy to create 100,000 new jobs net in the time ahead, and that's why that's in our programme for Government. Matters for the budget, of course, will be discussed by the Cabinet in due course. We'll have the principles and the strategy set out and assessed by Government on the production of the memo by the two governments, or by the two ministers.
The second and final question from Mr. Matsui from Gigi Press.
Thank you very much. I'm Matsui from Gigi. Mr. Prime Minister, in addition to your attendance to the G8 summit, you had this V4 summit as well as your first visit to Ireland. And how do you plan to apply the outcome of your visit to your future diplomacy? Now, Ireland, as well as the V4 countries, Poland, Hungary, Czech, and Slovakia, all had history of difficulties, but they have managed to win with their own hands freedom and democracy. And all of these countries have come to play a major role in EU. Now, through my visit, I believe I have been able to deepen solidarity with the countries with which we share universal values. So I would like to expand the European diplomatic frontier for Japan. In Ireland, we have about 50 Japanese companies, and in the four Visegrad countries, a total of 680 Japanese companies are deploying their businesses. I would like to continue support to these Japanese businesses, and while promoting cooperation on the economic front, through the early conclusion of Japan-EU-EPA, I shall further enhance the economic collaboration with the countries in Europe. Although Asia and Europe are geographically set apart, we have very close links in terms of security, and we share the interest and responsibility for global peace and stability. So in that regard, I place high priority on the countries in Europe, and so with our European partners, I shall continue enhancing our policy dialogue and policy coordination.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.